Hello friends, in this video I will be talking about factors affecting stakeholder relationships and corporate governance. Whenever management wants their proposals to be accepted, it needs votes of the shareholders. This we have studied earlier. If management wants to implement some decision or resolution, then shareholders will have to vote. Normally majority voting hota hai. So more than 50%, if they vote yes for the decision, then it gets approved. Thus, maintaining good relations with the shareholders is very important. How can a company improve its relations with the shareholders? Koi company कैसे shareholders के साथ relation अच्छा कर सकती है? See, normally shareholders are scattered all over India. Now, if let's say Reliance company है, Reliance का जो head office होगा, let's say it is in Mumbai, and those shareholders are from various states, or you never know, Mumbai में होके भी they've not actually been to the company. So now, how can the company improve the relation? So first point is by keeping AGMs. Annual general meetings, of course, it is mandatory every year rakhna hi padta hai. That is one way to actually build a relation with your shareholders. Shareholders come to the AGM, they question you, they get some answers, and that is how you build confidence. Next, press conference. You can hold press conferences to actually address the shareholders' queries. If shareholders feel that management is actually, you know, replying to our queries or answering to us, they feel good about it. Next, analyst conference calls. Analyst conference calls pe usually aap jitna bhi information analyst ko doge, they will pass it on to their clients who are actually your shareholders. So even that is one benefit. And of course, social media or email communication. You get newsletters through email, or there are some Twitter handles who will actually resolve the shareholder queries. So in this century, of course, social media and email communication is a must. So these are some ways to actually improve relations with the shareholders. Next is shareholder activism. Activism ka matlab hota hai dharna karna. So people will actually try to force their decision onto someone else by doing some dharna. Now, not exactly dharna, but let's understand what is shareholder activism. It is a process whereby some shareholders holding a significant stake, in order to increase the market value or to oppose negative policies of the management, can raise issues regarding management, propose changes in the policies, they can try to influence other shareholders to vote, they can file shareholder representation lawsuits, they can seek representation on the board of directors, they may vote for replacing the BOD or management. Understand what are these shareholders trying to do? Activism is nothing but letting someone hear your voice. You will do such things that people will hear you. Like in this case, shareholders holding a significant stake. Significant stake matlab, let's say I am holding 10 to 20%. It is significant. In order to increase the market value, this is my number one goal. I want to increase the market value of my shares, or I want to oppose some negative policies of the management. Agar mera ye do goal hai, then what can I do? If I am an activist, so I can raise issues regarding management. I will tell people that management is wrong. Then propose changes in those policies. Jo negative policies laaye hai, I will propose a change in those policies. Try to influence other shareholders. Now that my job is to be an activist, mujhe dharna karna hai, I want to be heard, I will go to all the shareholders possible and I will tell them, please vote with me. They can also file shareholder representation lawsuit. Representation lawsuit meaning, if shareholders are actually being oppressed, oppressed ka matlab hota hai, if the company's management is being very harsh on the shareholders, they are acting against the interest of the shareholders, then what they can do is they can go to any tribunal or any court and ask for representation. Then these shareholders actually get to be heard. They will actually try to give their inputs to the management. Please do this, please don't do this, etc., etc. सीक रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑन बीओडी. बीओडी पे अपना भी एक बंदा बिठा लो. लाइक यू सॉ इन क्यूमुलेटिव वोटिंग, माइनॉरिटी शेयर होल्डर्स ऑल्सो हैव अ राइट टू इलेक्ट देयर ओन डायरेक्टर ऑन द बीओडी, सो दे कैन सीक रिप्रेजेंटेशन हियर. ऑल्सो वोट फॉर रिप्लेसिंग द बीओडी और मैनेजमेंट. तो अगर कोई बंदा है जो शेयर होल्डर के इंटरेस्ट के अगेंस्ट काम करता है कंपनी में, रिमूव दैट पर्सन. नाउ नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज हॉस्टाइल टेक ओवर. हॉस्टाइल इज द ऑपोजिट ऑफ फ्रेंडली. तो इफ देर इज समथिंग हैपनिंग इन अ नॉन फ्रेंडली वे, दैट इज नोन एज हॉस्टाइल. सो हॉस्टाइल टेक ओवर इज अ नॉन फ्रेंडली अटेम्प्ट टू टेक ओवर अ कंपनी. इफ आई वॉन्ट टू एक्चुअली टेक अ कंपनी ओवर इन अ नॉन फ्रेंडली वे, मीनिंग इफ प्रमोटर्स जो है दे आर होल्डिंग लेट्स से 40%, ये प्रमोटर होल्ड कर रहा है. लेट्स से 40% इज हेल्ड बाय मी एंड 20% बाय पब्लिक. नाउ द प्रमोटर डज नॉट वॉन्ट मी टू गेट मोर देन 50% ऑफ कंट्रोल सो दैट आई डोंट बिकम द कंट्रोलिंग शेयर होल्डर. वॉट आई विल डू इन अ नॉन फ्रेंडली वे, मीनिंग प्रमोटर को मैं नहीं बताऊंगा, डेली आई विल बाय 1% फ्रॉम द पब्लिक टिल द टाइम माय शेयर होल्डिंग रीचेज 51%. This is known as a hostile takeover. Meaning, the promoter or the BOD or the management does not want me to take the company over, but I will still try to take it over. It is not supported by the company's management. Of course, kyunki wo hostile hai. The management might not want any intervention by new or outsider shareholders, so it may incline efforts towards interest of the current shareholders. Let's assume ये जो 40% है ना, आई डोंट ओन 40%, आई एम अ कंप्लीटली न्यू शेयर होल्डर. लेट्स अज्यूम 40% जो है इट इज हेल्ड बाई प्रमोटर्स एंड 60% इज हेल्ड बाई पब्लिक. नाउ कैन आई से आउट ऑफ द पब्लिक शेयर होल्डिंग ऑफ 60%, इफ आई लेट्स से आई बाय 5% डेली, if I buy 5% daily, one day I can reach let's say 55%. Now that is a threat to the company's management, because there is a new shareholder upcoming and the new shareholder is about to be a controlling shareholder. So the management would be reluctant to this, and so instead of letting a new shareholder come to the company, what they will do, they will incline their interest towards the interest of the current shareholders or old shareholders. And hostile takeover ka jo attempt hota hai, that will actually benefit the current shareholders, because now management will do whatever they can to actually protect the company from going in the hands of a new shareholder. Staggered board elections make a hostile takeover more costly and difficult, since directors will be re-elected or replaced every year. Understand, staggered board humne pehle bhi padha, staggered board ya staggered BOD, meaning every year there will be elections of directors. Now if there is any hostile takeover, and let's say agar koi naya controlling shareholder aa raha hai, now that controlling shareholder has the power to elect each and every director, but if you use staggered board elections, that new controlling shareholder will be cautious. ये कंपनी में तो स्टैगर्ड बीओडी है, मीनिंग एवरी ईयर डायरेक्टर विल हैव टू बी इलेक्टेड. अगर मेरे डायरेक्टर्स ने कुछ गड़बड़ किया, दे वोंट बी इलेक्टेड अगेन. सो दिस कैन बी वन वे ऑफ स्टॉपिंग द हॉस्टाइल टेक ओवर, और रादर आई कैन से इफ यू आर अ लेट्स से यू वॉन्ट टू टेक अ कंपनी ओवर इन अ हॉस्टाइल मैनर, यू विल बी अ बिट कॉशियस इफ दैट कंपनी इज यूजिंग स्टैगर्ड बोर्ड इलेक्शंस. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट है कॉमन वर्सेस सिविल लॉ. इट इज़ अ नॉन मार्केट फैक्टर. पहले वाले जो थे वो मार्केट फैक्टर्स थे. नाउ कॉमन वर्सेस सिविल लॉ, सो यू नीड टू नो द मीनिंग फर्स्ट. चेक, इन नेशंस विद कॉमन लॉ सिस्टम जजेस रूलिंग्स मे बिकम लॉ. मतलब जो जजेस रूलिंग देते हैं, लाइक लेट्स से इन इंडिया अगर सुप्रीम कोर्ट का जज आज कुछ रूलिंग देता है, टुमारो इट कैन बिकम अ लॉ. बट इन नेशंस विद सिविल लॉ सिस्टम judges have to mandatorily follow laws. Meaning, common law system jo hota hai, usme judges will be over and above the law. If the judge says something, that can be treated as a law. But in civil law countries, it is strict. Civil law countries mein judges cannot override the law. If the law says something, judge has to follow it. Judge cannot override it. Shareholders and creditors' interest are considered to be better protected in nations with a common law system. Of course, civil law is very strict. Agar law mein ek loophole nikla, judge cannot fix it. But in common law countries, judge can do each and everything. Even India is considered to be one of the common law nations. So shareholders and creditors' rights will be protected. If there is any loophole in the law which goes against the shareholders, judge will actually try to fix it. The intent of the law will be seen and not the wordings of the law. Thank you guys for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda.